A new generation has discovered home cooking, experimenting with ingredients, recreating family favorites, adding hometown flavor. Home cooks are the inspiration behind Our Table, a new line of modern kitchen and dining essentials from Bed Bath & Beyond. Classic cookware, trendy tools, beautifully designed dishware. Everything to cook more meals so you can invite more people to your table. Welcome to Our Table. Our Table is an invitation to everyone to call your friends and family, to celebrate hometown flavors, to cook and share the foods that tell our personal stories. And today, Our Table is located in Charleston. Joining at the table is Chef Vivian Howard. Vivian Howard is an acclaimed chef, best-selling author, and award-winning television host, and producer of A Chef's Life and Somewhere South on PBS. The owner of two restaurants in Charleston, South Carolina, and two in North Carolina, including Chef and the Farmer, Vivian's cooking is guided by the rural traditions of the tiny town of Deep Run, where she grew up. A gifted storyteller blending family, food, and tradition in a way that reminds people of where they came from. Her recipe for chicken leg quarters roasted over fresh corn and leeks with a green herb sauce is a family recipe that uses the drippings from rendering chicken to cook sweet corn. And her squash pudding casserole is a riff on a regional family recipe.
So we're gonna make something that I call a squash pudding casserole. And there are a lot of people that don't like squash because it's, you know, can get squeaky under.
It's spongy.
Yes.
I'm sorry, spongy.
We're gonna take it past spongy to caramelized and like full of flavor. So I'm gonna start with some butter.
Okay. So you're using this in a Dutch oven. Why specifically a Dutch oven? And I love the shape and the color of this, but why not just in a pan?
Well, I use Dutch ovens for almost everything. They conduct heat evenly, mm-hmm. they hold heat. Mm-hmm. It can go from the range to the oven. I hate washing dishes.
Hate it.
If I could like make this whole meal just in this, I would certainly be all about that.
That's what one pot cooking is all about. That's why Dutch ovens rock, and that's why this one does, because it is heavy and it retains so much heat, but it looks beautiful on the table, so I love that. All right, so butter's melting.
Butter's melting.
What are we doing next?
We're gonna add some garlic that we have minced.
Okay.
So I want you to slice this onion.
Okay, so just kind of like that?
Yes.
So one little tip for people at home, when you get halfway through an onion, just flip it over, saves your fingers. But a nice sharp knife, I love this knife.
Yes, and you know, this is a classic dish. We call it squash and onions. We're not real creative with our names.
and that's awesome.
The idea is to just cook it till it is like dark and caramelized and mushy and just like full of flavor.
Mm.
And this would be on every Sunday summer table.
Ugh,
and so
that.
We would have literally like a tablespoon of it on our plate.
Because it's rich.
Yes,
you
yes.
know what I mean?
All right, so every squash casserole has cheese in it. So I have chosen a fontina here.
Mm, I love fontina. It's got a little funk, but it also melts so beautifully. So you're just literally mixing that in on the stove.
Yes.
So the cheese is kind of cooling down the squash.
Yeah, we're gonna let it cool down the squash a little bit. And then I'm going to add an egg.
All right, I love it.
Just
interesting.
Stirring it in here.
Okay.
And let's dump this in here.
Oh, this is stunning, Vivian.
And so we're gonna put that in the oven for about 30, 35 minutes at 350.
And you made one ahead of time. I'll slide this one right over by it.
Yes, let's let it sit and cool down. I like it at room temperature.
All right, so we'll let this cool down and let's dive into the chicken.
So we're gonna cook some chicken with some corn. So we're gonna do one of my absolute most favorite things to do at the moment, which is cook something under chicken as it renders.
Mm.
And we're gonna do fresh sweet corn and leeks. So this is like summer in Deep Run. Sweet corn is like everybody's favorite vegetable. And so you're gonna take your ear of corn and we're gonna cut down.
And you're doing this is so smart because you can see all the kernels don't end up on the floor.
Exactly.
And you can see this knife is awesome for doing it because it's flexible.
Yes.
So if you can find what's called a utility knife, which Our Table makes, it's perfect for this job. Awesome, I'll take over.
All right.
What's next?
Okay, so now we're going to get ready to sear the skin of the chicken and brown it. So I'm gonna put some olive oil in my pan and I've got a very hot pan here.
But you got a very big pan.
I
think for these, especially with chicken thighs, you need a lot of space.
Yes, because we know that we do not want to crowd our pan.
Yep.
So here I have what we call leg quarters.
Okay.
Leg quarters are something that I grew up eating.
And you use the word rendered. When you say rendered, what are you referring to so people get it?
So I'm referring to browning the skin and having the juice and the fat of the chicken, like, cook out onto our corn.
I love it.
And so we're building flavor all along the way, and that's why I like to do this in one pan.
This pan is giving really even heat, super even distribution, and because of that, it will slowly render, right? Mm-hmm. And that is the key. You gotta render all the fat out to have the crispiest chicken possible.
Right.
Then we've got some leeks.
Yes, so, you know, this recipe is based on a dish that my sisters told me that my grandmother made in the summer. The Grandma Iris did not have any leeks.
That was a Vivian thing. Yes. You made it, you added your leeks. They probably love it.
Yeah, I added leeks because I love corn and leeks together. Yeah. And I think depending on how sweet your corn is, that can just kind of be one note. So the leeks give it dimension. So what we have here is chicken fat that has rendered.
My grandma would call it schmaltz.
Schmaltz.
Yeah.
We also have some fond, and fond is when flavor builds up on the bottom of the pan, and it is really important to the end flavor. So if you'll pass me the corn and the leeks.
Yep, both.
Yes. Cool. We're gonna just kind of saute them in here very briefly.
So if we move to a skillet now, is that like, am I Southern getting better? Is this a skillet?
This is a skillet. And one of the things I really like about this skillet is that you can take it from the range to the oven.
Yes. And then I've been picking some thyme.
You don't need to pick it.
Oh.
But that's okay.
Is that all right?
I was just gonna make it take a couple sprigs and put one down and then put a chicken leg quarter over it.
Just to what? Like perfume it?
Yeah, it's gonna scent the chicken, it's gonna scent the corn and the leeks. All right, so now we're gonna put this in the oven.
Okay.
400 for like 25 minutes.
Oh, that looks insane. Looks great. The chicken browns that much more. Mm-hmm. You can see the heat was totally retained on the pan. I love it. And all these little crispy bits, look at that.
Yes.
It's like a cracker.
You have, anytime you roast chicken on top of something, whatever is underneath it is gonna have a variety of textures.
Yeah.
So whatever is around the edge is gonna be more caramelized and chewy, and then what is directly underneath the chicken itself is gonna have the most flavor.
Yeah.
For
All
sure.
Right, show me how it's done.
So we're gonna start and put a little bit of this corn loveliness down here.
Oh my gosh.
Now we're gonna add something that's gonna really bring everything together. I love acid as a cook.
Okay.
And I love herbs. And so I have this little condiment that I make. It's called Little Green Dress.
Little Green Dress.
Yes, because Little Black Dress,
okay.
A lot of us women have them,
yes.
And they go with everything. They suit every occasion. So it's mint and parsley and capers and olives, olive oil, lemon juice, vinegar, and it's great. I mean, it would be great just here. It's great on here.
Yeah.
It
goes with everything.
It goes with everything. So if you love it as much as it sounds like you might, you can find this Little Green Dress recipe online.
Sweet. Okay. I'm trying the squash because you know I started this off as a skeptic. I'm trying the squash on its own and then I'm digging in.
Changed forever?
Stop. Like, stop. My knees buckled. Holy, it's so rich. It's so beautiful. There's no flour in it, but it tastes like, it's like mac and cheese.
It's mac and cheese. It reminds me of
lighter.
Mac and cheese. Yes,
and
absolutely.
Fresher. Oh, that's beautiful. And the caramelization on top is amazing. That, I'm like changed forever.
Thank you.
Changed forever.
Thank you, thank
wow.
you.
Wow. So let's try this. So a little bit of the chicken, a little bit of the squash, a little green dress. The leeks got really melty and nice.
Good. Are you kidding me?
Okay. So like Vivian said, there is a lot of chicken juice in the pan, also fat, and it's good. It's good fat. But because it's so robust, you do need something to cut it. The little green dress does that.
Right.
Holy cow, that is addicting. Oh my gosh, Vivian, this is so comforting. It just hits you right where you want it to. Thank you so much for opening up your heart and giving us a little taste of your kitchen. This is amazing.
Thank you, thank you.
So I hope you all cook this very soon and invite others to enjoy it. Our table, start with food and with love. Insane, dude.
Thank you.
Good.